For today's lesson, we'll be actually painting the drawings that we did previously before the holidays started. So, just a very quick introduction to what I need you to prepare is we're gonna have two containers. So one for washing, one for painting as usual. Your watercolor palette, your sketchbook with your drawings, and also brushes. So your brushes, you can use the one that comes with the palette itself, or you can use this kind that I bought from Popular. Okay. Lastly, we're gonna have what I have over here is some paper for us to test our colors on. So what I'm gonna start with, normally for watercolor, I like to start with something with the lighter colors first, because we're going to go from lighter colors to darker colors. So the lightest thing on this plate is probably gonna be the rice. So let's start with that. So for the rice, I'm gonna use a bit of some orange over here. So notice that I'm not painting directly onto my paper first. I'm just testing out the color first, making sure that it's the right one before I actually start. And every time before you want to take a new color, make sure you wash your brush before you dip it in again. If not, the colors will be dirty and you notice that I'm constantly adding water, because for the rice, I don't want it to be too dark, the color to be too dark. So it's just a very light wash of color. So you can just go over like this. For me, the marker that I used before that is actually a waterproof marker. You have to ensure that it's waterproof, because if not, your drawing will start smudging. For roasted chicken, the skin is gonna be slightly brownish, right? So I'm gonna start with some browns. Okay, we're gonna put some browns over here. Okay, but this color of this brown is not quite there yet, right? It's looking kind of it's quite off. Okay, so I'm gonna take perhaps some orange to mix with my brown. So right now we have brown and orange, okay. Getting closer. But normally the roasted meat, the roasted skin is slightly darker, right? So maybe I'm gonna throw in just a touch of black. Some black over here, not too much. So when I mix these three colors together, once again, brown, orange, and a bit of black. Okay, now I'm gonna use this for my chicken skin. Whitish, right? So it should be chicken, the color of the chicken. So perhaps maybe some yellow, orange, some orange plus a bit of white. Okay, for our chicken. Okay, remember not to use too much water for this. Because if you use too much water, what happens is that it's very hard to control your paint. Alright, so once I'm done with this, I'm gonna look for other colors that I can use my paint before I actually wash it off. So maybe I want to dilute it a bit more. I can use it for the soup, because the soup is slightly yellowish as well, right? The chicken soup. So just something like this, like an orange soup. And I look for other areas that might still use this color. Perhaps cucumber, not really. Tomatoes, not really. Perhaps the chili sauce over here. So the chili sauce is quite simple, it's just a mixture of orange and your reds. A spicy chili sauce. If you don't like chili sauce, you can always replace it with black sauce, dark sauce. Okay, so for mine, I'm going with chili. Okay, so it's a very nice bright red. So I can use this for my tomatoes as well. The inside of the cucumber is probably going to be a light yellow. So I'm going to take some yellow. Okay, this is looking a bit too bright. So maybe I need to mix some green as well. Okay, so it's a very light green color. So you can use this for the sliced tomatoes. Sliced cucumbers, I mean. Okay. So a very nice color over there. And for the side of the cucumber, probably a gonna use a darker green. Okay, so you can actually mix colors together to test out what colors you're gonna get. So I mixed yellow and dark green to give me this lime green-ish kind of color. So you can use this for the sides. It's okay if your paint hasn't dried and you see a bit of like smudging here and there. It's actually quite quite nice to look at as well. So I'm just gonna leave it as it is. Just remember, I'm using quite a little water, okay, every time I paint. You don't really have to put too much water for your paintings. So for this one, the tomatoes, I'm gonna use a bit of yellows. Okay, then I gotta take some greens. And probably throw in a bit of red. Yeah, for my tomatoes. What color should our plate be? So when I'm deciding a color for the plate, I look at what colors I already have. So I use some brown, some green. And normally for this, probably I'm gonna go with maybe a light blue plate. So let's test it out first. Okay, this color seems pretty nice. Okay, for the blue plate, okay, let's try. Okay, so very simple, just try to paint within the lines. If your painting goes out of the line, it's fine as well, okay, don't worry about it. Just try your best. Okay, for the thing at the back, I'm going to use a bit of dark blue. So that it has a difference. So the one in front is lighter, the one at the back is darker. So if you want to, you can add a bit of shadow at the side, for those of you who are up for the challenge. Okay, if not, it's perfectly fine as well, if you don't want to do that, to make your bowl a bit more 3D. So once I'm done, this is the bowl is done. Now I'm going to do the plate. So same thing. Oh, before you wash off, you actually can use the remaining of your blues for your little dish over here. So it can be... because it doesn't require much paint, right? So you can just use it. Okay, this part is gonna be a bit tricky because you have to paint without touching the paint that you've already done. So make sure that your paint is completely dry before you do this step, alright? So I'm gonna take some light blue, take some water, and we're gonna start painting. Be very careful around the edges. Okay. Okay. So with that, probably done with this chicken rice plate over here. So I'm gonna start with same thing for our nasi lemak rice. It's also gonna be a similar color to this. So we're gonna take some whites. Gonna put our test paper. And maybe we're gonna take some orange. Okay, if you like the color, you can just make sure you dilute it with some water first. Okay, once it's done, next up, what we're gonna paint. I'm gonna paint the larger things first. Okay, so probably I'm gonna have the next one is gonna be the what should we paint? Maybe we paint the fried chicken over here. So fried chicken is similar to the one that we did previously, the roasted chicken, but fried chicken is gonna be slightly more orangey. So it's gonna be brown. Okay. Brown plus a bit of dark browns. I mean a bit of black. And we're gonna take some orange. Okay, so it's a very nice golden brown color. So we're gonna use this for our chicken. So maybe I want to throw in just a touch of yellow as well. So you can actually paint the whole thing like this. So for the front part, I'm gonna use a bit more brown. As it moves downwards, it's gonna be slightly more yellowish. So you have a nice golden brown crispy chicken. Okay, so before you actually wash off your color, you can actually think of what else you can use this color for. So maybe I'm gonna use this for the roasted peanuts as well. So remember, we drew some peanuts. So similarly, this color can still be used for another thing, perhaps the anchovies, the ikan bilis, whatever you call it. Okay, so our ikan bilis, same thing. So these little things can all be similar in terms of colors. So once again, I use dark green, 1, 2, 3, and 4. The browns is just a little bit of brown, just to make it slightly more earthy. Okay, just paint the ota. Okay, alright, so I'm gonna use the same thing for, we're gonna paint the banana leaves as well. Okay, this one is a bit tricky because you need to paint around the objects that you've already done. They normally serve the belacan chili on a leaf as well, right? Okay, so once this done, oh okay, maybe we missed out the cucumbers at the side. The reason why I added a bit of purple so that it doesn't look too similar to my first plate that I have over here. Okay, and also it becomes a lot darker, right? So I can use this purple plus blue, dark blue. Okay, I quite like this color, it's quite nice. So paint our plate, purple and dark blue. You can use the same color for your fork and spoon as well. Okay, once this has been dried, so sometimes after it dries, you can add another layer. So if I'm gonna place this leaf on top, you're gonna see some shadow underneath this leaf, right, where it's not touching the plate. Okay, so for this roti prata, I'm gonna use some whites. Okay, some whites. Wash my brush. Orange. Wash my brush. Perhaps some browns. Okay, wash my brush again. White, orange, and brown. And maybe some orange over here. Orange and white. So I have white, orange, brown for this one. And white and orange for the bottom one. So why do I have these two different colors? So this one over here, I'm going to use it for the roti prata itself. So take some water, take this paint, and just brush it across very lightly. Okay, brush it across, give it some color. So this will be our roti prata. Alright, so now before it dries, I'm gonna take this color now, this mixture of brown and orange and maybe some white. Okay, so you're gonna get this like this color over here. Just give it some. Take your brush and just tap your roti prata like this. Okay, once it's done, let it dry. So we're gonna paint the next one. We're gonna paint the teh tarik that we have over here. So this teh tarik is gonna be tricky. So it's gonna be milk. Normally, what is teh tarik? So teh tarik is gonna be a tea with milk, right? So you have some browns over here. We take some white. So I need some orange, just to get a nice tea color. And we're gonna add some white for our milk. So you get this very milky brown, right? Okay, this milky brown, which we all use for our teh tarik. So we simply just paint over this whole thing. Okay, like this. And wash it off slightly. So this foam that we have at the top, it's gonna be lighter, okay? It's not gonna be as dark as the one below. Okay, so this is a very nice golden, very nice mixture of curry color, right? So I'm gonna use this and paint my curry. Okay, so make this. So you get a very nice, very yummy looking curry color. Let's try a green plate instead. Okay, not bad. I like this green. Maybe this green plus our darker green. Alright, so let's try that. Okay, this green over here. Okay, not bad. So perhaps maybe I want to try mixing my green with a bit of yellows to see what we get. Okay, so green and yellows. Yellow and green over here.
It's a really nice bright green, right? Okay, once again, you can see that I'm not using a lot of water. I'm using just enough for myself to paint.
So similarly, like what we did for this one, the bowl over there, the front is gonna be lighter green. The back is gonna be a darker green. Okay, so same thing. When you paint this, just make sure you don't cover the. You don't paint onto your roti prata. So it's always a good idea to mix a bit more color of this, so that you don't run out of it so quickly. Like for this case, I'm slightly running out of color already. Okay, once I'm done, I'm gonna take a bit of darker green for the ones at the back. Some darker green over here. I want it to be slightly like a clear glass cup, so I want to get something like a silver. So I'm gonna try taking some dark blue plus some browns. Maybe blue and brown give you something like this, like a grayish kind of color. Then I'm gonna take some whites. Okay, so this is our. We're gonna have a. This is how I make my gray. So I'm gonna just paint over. I'm just gonna paint this whole thing. A slight gray tone for this. And paint these grooves as well. Okay, so this is for our gray cup over here. Alright, so this is. So similarly, once you have a new color, if you haven't used up the color, you can think of where else you can use this for. So since we're on the topic of using gray color, right? I can actually use this gray for perhaps maybe this plastic container and this glass container for the pepper. So I'm gonna do that. Use the grays first for these areas. Add some shadows at the side. Perhaps maybe some shadow for this cup over here. Notice I'm painting the sides first. Okay. Jump right over here. Alright, now I'm gonna take a bit of browns and orange. Now you're probably wondering what I'm gonna use for this, right? I'm gonna use this for the bread itself. So I'm gonna use this as a. But when I paint, I'm gonna paint lines on like this blocks of lines. Okay, then I might scrap that. Let's have some browns over here. Nice toasted bread. Okay, and I'm gonna paint a bit of browns onto this as well. Here and this part. Notice I'm leaving this the center part a bit brighter. Okay, so get our toasted bread. And I'm gonna use a bit of darker brown. Wait for it to dry first. Dry it slightly. Okay, so I'm gonna add some lines on it. So when you actually toast your bread, you see some lines, right? Okay, just to make it more interesting. Once again, if you want to do this in water, this step in watercolor, you can actually add on with your color pencils as well. Perfectly fine. Okay. So you get this really nice egg yolk color, right? Okay, for the egg white, we are just gonna leave it white. We're not gonna paint it. I'm gonna mix it. I'm gonna throw in a bit of brown to make it lighter, slightly. Okay, so it's a mixture of black and brown for our dark sauce over here. So I'm just gonna paint this very nice color over here. Okay, so you can go ahead and paint this. Okay, you can see it's very, very dark, right? Even though I've already mixed in a bit of browns. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in slightly. Okay, for the side, I'm gonna use this color as it is, but for the top, I'm gonna wash it off slightly. Okay, I'm gonna wash it off. Then get diluted with. After diluting with water, I can use it to paint. So you're gonna get a lighter version of this soy sauce. Okay, just for a bit of details at the top. Okay, for the kaya in the middle. Alright, if you want to, you can change it to something else. You can use the yellow as well for maybe yours is a butter bread, okay? So this is fine. I'm gonna use green for this. For my teacup, I'm gonna leave it white. We're gonna leave a white cup. So I'm just gonna paint the plate itself. Same thing for the spoon. I want it to be a porcelain spoon, so I'm not going to touch the spoon as well. So you're going to avoid painting the spoon and the cup. So be careful when you go around this. If you accidentally paint onto it, it's fine as well, don't worry. Let's try our best. Okay, so you have a white, porcelain cup and a white spoon. I'm going to repeat this red for this plate as well. So I'm assuming that there is going to be the same material. Okay. Notice that you don't really have to add white to paint your egg. Okay, your paper itself is already white, so you don't really have to use white paint anymore. Normally when I use white paint, it's just for mixing colors. But if I want to get white, I just leave it blank. I just leave it out. Okay, a red plate over here looking pretty nice. Okay, and our plate for the bread as well. Alright, so be careful with this. Okay, almost done. Oops. If you actually painted outside of the lines, it's fine, alright? Don't worry about it. Don't stress over it. But try your best to paint within the lines. Okay. Almost done. Maybe I'm just gonna use red for this. Just make it simpler. So we're gonna do a bit of shadow for this. So the shadow is very simple. You start from here, you paint across, and you just block out this portion below to make it look like it's on top of this bread itself. So I'm gonna wash it off slightly, make it slightly lighter. Okay, and we're gonna do a bit of shadow. Same thing, we're gonna do a triangle that mix from here to here. So now it looks like this bread is on top of this. It's a bit tricky, but if you follow, you can give it a try and try to follow it. So this is pretty much it. So I'm just gonna zoom in a bit. Okay, and thank you for watching. Okay, see you. Bye bye.